Today we will discuss the chapter gravitation. Gravitation. Do you know what is gravitation? You have noticed that the satellites are revolving around Earth. Earth revolve around Sun. Moon revolve around Earth. This type of things are happen. That means they revolve around. That means all planets revolve around Sun due to gravitational force of Sun. It's okay. Earth has also its force of gravitation, that means the pulling force of Earth. When you throw any object vertically upward, actually this law of gravitation is given by Newton. When you are sitting inside his garden, notice that the apple falls freely towards him. He thought that why the apple falls towards him, that means due to the pulling force of Earth, that means the gravitational force exerted by Earth. Again he thought that this type of pulling force is in any other planet or not, in Sun or not. Therefore, he derived some laws. We'll discuss those, okay? All motion laws of motions are mainly given by Newton. First chapter, you have derived the number of motion equations. These are also given by Newton. So, gravitation. The planets revolve around Sun or the total solar system revolve around any other constellations are there which are revolving around other. These things are mainly known as, due to the force which they are moving, this is known as gravitational force. Why the Earth revolves around Sun? Because Sun has more mass, so it provides more gravitational force. Therefore, Earth moves around the Sun. Similarly, why Moon revolves around Earth? This is also due to the gravitational pull of Earth. You know that Moon has also gravitational force, but it is very less because mass of Moon is very less than the Earth. Listen to me. The planet or sub-planet or satellite, okay, which are revolving around any other means, revolving around a more massive object. It's okay. I cannot revolve any stone which mass is more than me, okay, around me. It's okay. So, Moon has very less mass as compared to Earth, therefore Moon revolves around Earth. Similarly, Earth revolves around Sun due to more mass of Sun. More mass, it provides more gravitational force. We'll discuss this. This thing you know that any object revolves around in a circular path, it needs a necessary amount of centripetal force, which you have discussed in circular motion. Here the Earth provides necessary amount of centripetal force to the Moon due to which Moon revolved around Earth. The necessary amount of centripetal force provided by Earth is due to gravitational force of Earth. Similarly, the necessary amount of centripetal force provided by Sun is due to gravitational force of Sun due to which all the planets are revolved around it. It's okay? Now we'll discuss the Newton's law of gravitation. You just see this properly because 1-3 mark question will come or a 5 mark question will come from this. So gravitational force, actually 3 mark questions are coming. State and explain Newton's law of gravitation. If any numerical associated with it, then it carry 5 mark. It's okay. So state and explain the Newton's law of gravitation. Actually gravitational force is a pulling force. Okay. So let us two objects are there. It's okay. They are attracting towards each other. This is actually gravitational law. Law of gravitation said that two objects have attractive force. First, you understand what is the gravitational law. Okay, law of gravitation. Let's say you are taking two bar magnets. This is the North Pole, this is the South Pole. They have attractive force. If this magnet is more larger, it attracts very strongly to this. If it is more larger, it also attracts very strongly to this. That means, if mass of this object, either this object or this object increases, in that case the force of attraction also increases. It's okay? That means force of attraction is directly proportional to product of first object and second object. It's okay? Similarly, if you place this magnet more distance, in that case force is decreases. If these two magnets are closer to each other, then force of attraction will increases. If these two magnets are far away, then the force of attraction will decreases. That means force of attraction between these two magnets is decreases according to the square of the distance. Why square of the distance? This is derived from Kepler's law. Kepler's law is not in your syllabus. We'll discuss it later on, but we'll escaping the Kepler's law. Okay? If you little bit change the distance between two magnets, more amount of force will reduce. It's okay? That means if you little bit close to it, then the more amount of force will exerted. Therefore, force is inversely proportional to square of the distance. Actually, these two things combiningly known as Newton's law of gravitation. It's okay? That means F is proportional to M1 into M2. F is proportional to 1 by d square. So these two things in language we will write law of gravitation. So just write down. The force of attraction between any two objects is directly proportional to product of their mass and inversely proportional to square of distance between their center. That means the force of attraction between any two objects, if you are taking inside the earth surface or where, or between earth and sun, or between earth and moon, it's okay, or between any two objects, you and me, like this. So the force of attraction between any two objects is directly proportional to product of their mass and inversely proportional to square of distance between them. It means mathematically we'll derive this. Consider two objects. Let's say this is one object, this is one object, A, B, mass M1, mass M2, distance between their center is, let's say, D. Consider two objects, A and B, of mass M1 and M2 are a separation D between the center. So according to law of gravitation, F is proportional to M1 into M2 and F is proportional to 1 by D square, or F is proportional to combining relation is M1 M2 by D square, or F is equals to some constant G into M1 M2 by D square. It's okay? So F is equal to G into M1 M2 by D square. What is G? G is a proportional constant known as universal gravitational constant. G is a proportional constant known as universal gravitational constant. So up to this much the derivation, G, F is equal to G into M1 M2 by D square, where G is known as universal gravitational constant. It's okay? So you are able to know that F is equal to G into M1 M2 by D square, or G is equal to F into D square by M1 M2. So what is the value of G? One scientist, Henry Cavendish, produced the value of G or calculated the value of G like this. G is equal to, actual value is 6.673, or in your book it is given some cases 6.67. into 10 to the power minus 11. What is the unit here? F is force. Force means Newton. D square means meter square by mass M1 into M2 means kg into kg, kg square. It's okay? So value of G is 6.673 into 10 to the power minus 11 Newton meter square by kg square. Clear about this? Now some 1 mark questions are coming from this. This the derivation comes 3 mark question, okay? From this also 1 mark questions are coming. Just see properly. You know that F is equal to M1 into M2 by D square. So if you increase the distance by 2 times, increase the distance between the two objects by 2 times, So 2d square means 4d square. Here the denominator will be 4. So 2 times means 2d whole square means 4d square. So denominator will be 4. That means the force of attraction reduced by 1 by 4 times. If distance increased by 6 times, then the force reduced by 1 by 36 times. It's okay? If both mass get double, both mass get double and distance also double, then what will happen? Both mass get double means 2, 2, here 2d square, so 2 cancel, so force remain unchanged. It's okay? If distance is half, then what will be the force? Then force is increased by 4 times. Why? Half means half d whole square. Means 1 by 4 d square, 4 will move to the upper. That means the force will increase by 4 times. Also you can tell me or you can puzzle that if gravitational force is an attractive force, and you know that the value of G is a universal constant. G is a universal constant. It is constant all over the universe. Wherever you may go, the value of G is very less. That is 6.67 × 10⁻¹⁺ Newton meter square by kg square. But value of G actually, it is constant all over the universe. It never changes. It's okay. It is a universal constant. But you may get puzzled that if gravitational force is an attractive force, that means every object in the universe attracts each other. So my question is, why you are not attracted by other students? Or if you are two students are sitting close to each other, why they are not attracting? Chair and tables, why they are not get attracting each other? Actually, this has happened due to their mass is very much negligible, but G value is very less. G value is 6.67 × 10⁻¹⁺. 10⁻¹⁺ means 1 by 10 to the power 11. So G value is very negligible value, very less. So your mass is maximum 100 kg, around up to 100 kg. So in that case, 10⁻¹⁹ means very negligible force. If it is a very negligible force, so you cannot acquaint or you cannot feel the gravitational force. It's okay? What is gravitation and what is gravity? I am telling you here, what is gravity? The force of attraction between any two objects is due to the gravitational force. Also, Earth gravitational force is there. But the Earth attracts towards each other every object. That means the pulling force of Earth or gravitational force of Earth is known as gravity. Due to the gravitational force of Earth, the ball of any object is pulling towards the Earth with an acceleration. That is known as acceleration due to gravity. It's okay? So gravitational force of Earth is known as gravity, and the acceleration produced due to that force is acceleration due to gravity. It's okay? So you know about the questions and the Newton's law of gravitation. The next part, importance of Newton's law of gravitation. This is very easy. That means the Earth rotates around the Sun or Moon rotates around the Earth. The artificial satellite launching, they also revolve around the Earth due to gravitational force. Every object attracts towards the Earth surface, or we live on the Earth surface. Our houses are also placed on the Earth surface due to the gravitational force of Earth. Tide also produce in the sea, it will produce due to the gravitational pull of maybe Moon, maybe Sun. It's okay? So this is all about the Newton's law of gravitation. Now we'll discuss some numericals based upon the Newton's law of gravitation from your book, examples, in-text questions, and also some previous year questions and important questions here. Each part, phase by phase, we will cover one by one. It's okay?